her memory is a hypothalamus complaint. So, what are the herbs? So, the herbs are and red clover. No. Does anyone not know red clover? Good. Have you eaten red clover blossoms in the field? Always not. They're delicious. Anyone with hormones, well, this is your herb. It is the sweetest, most delicious, satisfying. If you're out working in your fields or gardens and you see a red clover blossom, always ask before you take. Plants are alive, just like we are. You don't just go up to somebody and take a bite out of it. So, you know, take a blossom and eat it. You will be so amazed at how delicious it is. Isn't that incredible? I am so excited that red clover blossoms are beginning to bloom in the garden. Yes! It's purple. It should be more than purple. And if you buy it at the store and it's brown, don't buy it. You know, it should look like the plant looks in the field when you buy plants, or better still, grow your own. So, passion flower. Oh, I'm so sure there's no passion flower here. Yeah, she has billions of them in her garden. Do you have ones that'll winter over?
Well, it depends. I'm on four, so
yeah,
I have trouble. But yeah, may possibly come down. You can get your little shelter there and you can eat them.
Yeah, okay.
We just have a little bit of Japanese.
So passion flower is, who does not know what passion flower looks like? Okay. Passion flower looks like a flower that came from outer space.
Yeah.
It is.
Or Walmart.
And
Walmart.
No, yeah, I mean, they're just so incredibly bizarre. They have sort of windy things growing out of them and beautiful bright colors and the purple, pink, purples are my favorite. And they're just incredible, and they are the herb. You know, if you're going to pick St. John's wort, blue vervain, and passion flower are going to be the three herbs that you should all have in your garden, because they will treat more different plants than anything else. So passion flower is a nerving sedative. I mean, I have given it to people during their daytime hours when they're extremely stressed out, but I do prefer to save it for the evening, because you wouldn't want to be responsible for somebody to drive their tractor into the barn wall. So it is a sedative, it can knock you out. And it is a beautiful plant and wonderful vine. It's gorgeous, stunningly beautiful. So there's also spikenard. And I am not as familiar with spikenard yet. It's a plant I want to get to know. So I'm not gonna, I don't want to teach about plants that haven't actually had personal experience with, so I'll be quiet on that one, but it is on the list. Ginseng is also on the list. And ginseng is an herb that I prefer to save for people who are over the age of 50. I don't agree always with all the Chinese philosophy, because it's kind of limiting, I think. But this is one that is such a major adrenal stimulant as well, that if you start taking it too much when you're young, you have nothing left to take when you're older. So ginseng is the grandfather plant. So it's the one that is very revered for us who are old enough